Longitudinal studies help to paint a clearer picture of society by helping us understand how life is changing. They observe the same groups of people repeatedly over a period of time. Birth cohort studies follow groups of people born at a particular time. Every few years, researchers contact these people to ask them questions about their lives. In household panel studies, whole households are surveyed, including parents and their children. Study members are interviewed every few years to show how life is changing in homes across Britain. When designing a study, researchers might be interested in the population as a whole, or they might select a group of people based on factors such as their age or health. Data can be collected from study members face-to-face, on the phone, by post, or online. Many also take part in health and cognitive assessments. Information from the studies helps to improve people's lives by informing government policy in areas such as health, education, and employment. Longitudinal studies follow the same groups of people over long periods of time to see how they change. There are various different types. Cohort studies chart the lives of people with shared characteristics. The most well-known are the UK's birth cohorts, which follow groups of people born within the same time period. Household panel studies are different. They focus on whole households as they change, including families, housemates, and people who join and leave the household. Record linkage studies link administrative information, for example, about health and education, for the same individuals over time. In prospective studies, individuals are followed over time and data about them is collected as their characteristics and circumstances change. In retrospective studies, individuals are asked to recall important events from their past. Cross-sectional studies are different to longitudinal ones. They interview a new sample of people each time the study takes place. Longitudinal studies collect a great deal of information through questionnaires. An interviewer might ask questions either face-to-face or over the phone, or the participants might complete the questionnaire on their own. Assessments can be used to show how study members think and how their cognitive ability is developing or declining over time. These exercises usually take the form of questions or a set of activities to assess numeracy, literacy, and problem solving. Many studies ask participants to take part in health assessments. They might measure the height and weight of study members or examine lung and heart function. Studies are increasingly interested in participants' mental health and well-being and ask questions to assess people's state of mind. Several studies collect biological samples, such as blood or saliva. Genetic information can be extracted from these samples, and the samples can also provide measures of people's health, known as biomarkers. When designing a longitudinal study, the first thing that needs to be decided is who the study will focus on. Researchers might be interested in the population as a whole, or could select their sample of participants based on factors such as age, location, or health. To select a suitable sample of participants, researchers need a list of everyone in the population of interest. Examples of lists that have been used include hospital, birth, and child benefit records. For surveys of the whole population, studies can use a record of all addresses in the UK, maintained by the post office. Study teams usually select a sample that is larger than their ideal sample size to take into account the fact that response rates are never 100%. Another important consideration is attrition, that is, participants dropping out of the study over time. Some longitudinal studies select a subsample of participants because the target population is larger than the study needs. Each time longitudinal studies collect new information about their participants, they are adding rich new data to what we already know about them. Longitudinal studies allow us to see how key life events, like marriage, having a baby, or losing a job can change the course of a person's life. They also help to show us how patterns of behaviour change as people get older. For example, how smoking, drinking, and diet change over time. The studies reveal how the circumstances that someone faces early in their life have an impact on later outcomes. For example, we know from longitudinal studies that experiencing poverty in childhood can affect a person's educational attainment or their physical and mental health many years later. Being able to answer questions like these mean that longitudinal studies can be vital sources of evidence for policymaking in areas such as health, education, and employment.